Hi everybody, it's me. Welcome to today's co-video. This is the 30th of March, and I'll start where I usually do. My temperature today is 97.5, I really have been doing an excellent job of staying at home, and I realize that a lot of you are not. And I know people are struggling out there, and people are having a hard time, so you know, I'm going to start with a be good to each other right at the beginning here. Do something good for somebody else, and that can help us all. I think I'm going to talk a little bit. What I'm going to talk about today is some interesting news, and one of them is that China had a very good plan for fighting contagions. China's plan got started in 2003, after 2003, and they came up with a great plan for tracking all sorts of issues and all sorts of things related to an epidemic, as that case as it started. And that was very good. It was a great plan, except that when COVID actually came, it all fell apart. And it fell apart because I think that there was some issues with people not wanting to offend people in government, and there was suppression of data, and eventually we found out a lot by basically whistleblowers. So sometimes government can actually stand in a way. You need to trust in a time of a pandemic. You need to trust the scientists and the doctors. Those are the people who know what they're doing. I know some of you just tuned in today to Governor DeWine's press conference and heard that school for K-12 has been suspended till the 1st of May. Kids will be staying home until that long. So government sometimes does good things, and you know, you have to respond to look for the people who are the helpers. That is my big, whether they're in government or whether they're your neighbor, the helpers are the ones that are going to get us through that, and follow them. They have the good information. So China kind of fell apart. They had a great plan for tracking contagion, for shutting it down. It just didn't work. Let me tell you about a great story. And this is a story coming out of Iceland. I call this Iceland, baby. Iceland is a place where they have done a lot of testing kind of randomly. They've done some extra working on random testing, and we've actually learned quite a bit. Now, going out and testing well people is one of the things I've proposed a lot in this series, but I'll tell you, I never knew somebody was actually doing it, and I found out that Iceland is doing that. They're going out and they're testing well people, and they have found out something very, very interesting. And the thing that they have found out is there is a lot of people who have very, very mild cases of this. And they could be around us right now. There could be people who are asymptomatic, who are basically carrying it and maybe spreading it, or maybe they've resolved their infections. We just don't know. So there is a great, I strongly encourage that we move towards testing people who are well, and so that we can see if they can be, they can return back to the workforce. I mean, that's one of the things we'd like to do. And with that knowledge, we can maybe have some people stay at home, some people go to work, and this will help us solve a lot of the problems that we have going on. All right, last thing I want to talk about today is I just want to keep you all aware of where things are. I'll tell you this. This curve here shows you the United States. In the United States, the cases are not leveling off. The cases are leveling off for China. They have leveled off for China. China's had this pretty much under control. They still have a small number of cases each and every day, mostly from imported cases, but they're managing quite well. So is South Korea. As you can see from this graph, which was coming from the Johns Hopkins data source, you can see that the United States is still climbing at a very, very fast rate. And you can see also, I want to tell you that the rate increases in the state of Ohio are looking like they're starting to curve more horizontal. When the curve is horizontal to the x-axis, that means that everything is under control. China's under control. South Korea is under control. And even Ohio, early predictions, and I will caution you about early predictions, but early predictions suggest that these efforts that we have done for social distancing are actually working. Now, despite that, we are seeing cases. This is I showed this on the co-video from, I believe, Saturday. We are seeing more cases in Northeast Ohio. There are cases in four counties here. You can see that Cuyahoga County leads the pack with the most number of cases, followed by Lorain. That's our county, and followed by then Medina and Erie. It is going to be everywhere. There is no doubt about it. One of the things that we have found is that people don't really adhere to sheltering in place until they see actual cases. But the truth of the matter is, if you're sheltering in place when there are actual cases, you're 5 days too late. You're about a week late in that effort. So you may have already been exposed to one of those persons who didn't know. One thing I can tell you, I can be very, very, assure you very, very much that this is a very, very infectious kind of microorganism. Last thing I want to talk about is one of the things that I've noticed. My wife was reminding me that it seems a little bit cumbersome to get these absentee ballots. There will be a site on the college website if you're interested in an absentee ballot for the upcoming election. And for those of you who are viewing this from other parts of the country, I think we're all going to be doing a lot of absentee balloting in the future for almost every election going forward, at least in the primary seasons as it's still going on. And you can get an absentee ballot by writing to your local boards of election. We will have on the website of the college places where you can download a form to get an absentee ballot. It needs to be sent to the Lorain County Board of Elections, or if you don't live in Lorain, one of the other boards of election, county boards of election, and they will mail you out a ballot. The reason I say it's one of those things you want to do earlier than later, I sent mine out yesterday, my request, because it is going to take a while to get that back. And then to one of the nice things about doing a at-home ballot, you can think about it and really put some thought into the election. And so I would strongly urge you to do that and get on that pretty early on. I'm going to leave you with the same slide that I always talk about. Be good to each other. You know, there are plenty of good things happening on. Continue to do good things for each other. And that will be, we'll all get through this. We are going to get through this. There is plenty of history that says that we get through this. Hopefully more of us get through this than don't. I know most of us will get through this, but still, let's try to get as many people surviving this and doing well as we possibly can. Just remember, be good to yourself, and may you persist like a lentivirus. Thank you.